What's going on, guys? It's TheNineVoltDevil over here, and today I am pretty high up in the end. Over here on the Almost Vanilla server, we have been getting an influx of new players, and we had an Enderman farm, and every time you go to it, it seems like it's in use. So I'm building a second one, and had a few requests, two people, to actually see how the guts of this thing kind of works. So this is me building the farm. As you can see, I have tons of materials on me because this is a place you do not want to run down and restock. So we'll start off. I'm just going to show you one layer, and then I'll probably fast forward, but what I'm placing down now is where the Enderman will actually land. I'm making these spawner beds 11 across, and 1 second. Sorry about that. I'm making these 11 across. The extra stone is more of pathway walking for me. Some people, when they build Enderman farms, they leave out unnecessary stone that they don't need. Covering up the redstone. Redstone actually acts like a block. That's why it's going up a little bit. This is where I'm going to put the pistons. And again, this isn't a tutorial how to build this. This is just what I'm doing. I'm just letting you know what I'm doing step by step. So after we make our ring, we're going to add our pistons. So let me finish this up. Boring stuff. Almost done. So the ring is finished. Now we need to count. Again, I said I'm doing 11. The old Enderman farm is 14. I was going to do have this area where two people could farm at the same time, but there's something weird with a server and the number of entities that could be in the area. I'm not sure what the math is or whatnot. But I noticed that the entities kind of max out around 30 for some odd reason. And something else that was kind of weird was in the other farm, which is 250 blocks away, if I'm over here working and someone's in that farm, there's like 57 entities over there. And then occasionally when if someone's over there messing with the Enderman farm, and where they only had like 25 or 30 entities, and all of a sudden I come over here, just the few pads that I have, and I think I only went 10 high so far. I think my goal is 16, but it's like 57 entities over here. So I don't really think the more spawning beds that I have is going to increase the number. I think it has something to do with the server. So anyway, I'm just going to build one side. I'll probably have it open on Thursday, so we can have two Enderman farms up and going. But anyway, so as you saw, I put up the pistons. Now I need to pretty much cover it up another layer. This allows Endermen are three high. So, and this is very simple redstone things. It's we're using the tripwire hooks and redstone. We have no repeaters or anything like that. So, as you can see, the platform's three high. The pistons are right in the middle. We're going to finish this ring, and then we're going to lay down our redstone. We're just going to have the redstone all over the blocks on top of the pistons and where the tripwire hook is. So, when Endermen spawn, their head is going to be in the string. It's going to trigger the tripwire hook, and It's going to go through the wire and trigger all of the pistons to push the Enderman off. They're going to fall all the way down to where I have these vines. The vines are going to catch them, and then they're going to fall 43 blocks, and they should be one-hit kills. So, now the redstone's done, and that's now we got to lay the string. That's one side done. And the other side done. So yeah, rinse and repeat. It's very boring. A lot of people have noticed, hey, why aren't you, and mumble, why don't you have a mic? When you're up this high and you're shifting, and let's say someone's having a conversation in mumble, and I want to add to that conversation, and I use control to talk, and control and shift don't like each other, and I'll pretty much fall to my doom. So no offense to people if I'm not on a mic while I'm in the end. It's just I don't want to fall. And so far, no deaths. Well, actually, I take that back. I did punch an Enderman in the face because he was in my way. And he didn't like that, and he killed me. So, but I haven't fallen yet. So, anyway, we're going to speed this up because I'm going to do this about 5 or 6 more times or until I'm run out of materials. And we'll see you in a little bit. Endermen cannot spawn on bottom half slabs. They can spawn on the top half slabs, just not bottom. So, ran out of materials, so I'm gonna test this height for a while. And right now I'm just covering it up, so Endermen cannot spawn here. So they're forced to spawn on the pads and push them off. But yeah, that's what I'm doing with these half slabs. Looks like we're almost done, though. But yeah, this is it's pretty boring, but it is a really neat farm. Especially when you have a really good pick or really good piece of armor you want to repair. It's nice to spend a couple minutes in an Enderman farm and get the levels you need. And a lot of people asked if, hey, Nine, do you need any donations, stuff like that. I appreciate it, but this gave me a perfect opportunity to use a lot of my materials. I'm going to commit suicide here. Alright, let's see how far we were. Ah, I tricked you. Yeah, I have the whole top covered with water, and that's mainly because Endermen do not like water, so they will not spawn on it, and if they actually do touch it, it hurts them. So, this is the farm. Yeah, as you can see, they're one-hit kills. And I have it set up, this fence. You can just put your back to it and strafe left to right. Also have it where another person can't steal your experience from being on the other side. They would have to be really rude and be in the same area you are. So hopefully we don't have any rude people on our server, but at least people can watch. See, I was going to make another Enderman farm so two people can be in at the same time on single player. That would actually work good, but for some odd reason on this bucket server, if I was to do that and there would only be 25 to 30 Endermen that spawned in this little chunk, then it would be split in both those sides no matter how many spawner pads I had. So then it would be like 15 to 10, and that would just actually be horrible. So just put my stuff up, and but yeah, this should be open pretty soon. I'm pretty happy with it. Let's take a walk to the other farm, and it should, in theory, have more Endermen. Should be like 40 to 57, since I've been working over in this area. So if my theory is correct, it should be beneficial for two people to use both farms at the same time, since they are kind of far apart. I just like the effect that the glass gave. I've tested it. Don't be scared. You can't really chunk an ender pearl unless it lands. So technically, I guess you can chunk an ender pearl on that fence there. Don't do it. You might die. I have a trash can on the other side, but still trying to figure out if we want to make people run, or should we put another portal? I'm not sure. Oh yeah, there's tons more Endermen here, just because I've been working in that other area. So yeah, two functional farms now. And as the server grows, I might build a third. You never know. So, I enjoy building these farms for the server. I'm glad that it's not a build that's just sitting there collecting dust. People actually get some use out of it, but like I said, it is kind of sucks when you wanna go build that. You wanna use the farm and someone else is using it, so that's the reason of building the second one. Recently, we have built. I redid the zombie farm, and it's all prettified, and we have a creeper farm now. So you guys that need gunpowder, come over here. Now please pay attention to the sign. It basically says do not stand close, or things will explode. You kinda wanna stand on the wood, not the glowstone. And I didn't bring a sword, but I keep putting things in these item frames and they keep getting knocked off. And that's because people are standing on the glowstone making things explode, so. Right. The reason why it's so fast, just in case you guys don't know, is because it's actually kind of right underneath us, is where the spawner hub is. Just put some stuff up in my storage. I was showing some people, I don't know if you see all the pistons that are below. That's just so I can hide light sources. Pigmen. It's a pain in the butt. The only thing I hate about this, using this portal to get to my storage, is occasionally these pigmen will aggro me and kill me before I can zone in. But we also made some improvements to our storage. Too many enderpearls. A single chest is all you need. But yeah, we're running out of room, so we expanded. The side is wood material. I don't know how we got a golem in here, but he's chilling out. So yeah, plant stuff, dirt, grass, wood. On this side is all of my stone stuff. So any type of stone type block, another brick, another rack, smooth stone, mossy stone, cobble, chiseled stone. This, we need to, I don't know what happened here. I thought I had them in the item frames. That's not on the item frame. Yes, I've been doing that much work. If you notice my Christmas pick, it is almost dead. I'm trying to kill it. It won't die. But yeah, it's nice being organized again. Our sort chest now, I think, is one. This is the bottom layer is for all of our colored things, and as you can see, the wool, the glass, and the hardened clay. So it's nice to have a stockpile of a certain color. Wazi hated it when I would just throw random things in the chest, so she, if it gets more than two, I need to sort it ASAP. Another cool thing, snapshot just came out, stackable doors. As you can see, it takes up a lot of rooms when you can't stack doors, but other than that, guys, that's pretty much it. I will see you guys on the flip side, and those on our server, Enderman Farm should be up today. Take it easy.